Hello everyone, Alexander Flores here, and in this video, we're going to go over how we can update and read Cognito user attributes. So this is useful if you want to keep track of a specific data point on each user. In this video, we'll be using the current user's plan as an example. Typically, you'll want this to be only selected between a few different strings and behind a paywall. However, for simplicity, we're just going to assume the user can enter whatever string they want and just update their plan like that. So here I'm on the Cognito dashboard. We can click on attributes to get started. And if we scroll down, we see a number of predefined attributes that we can update, but we're looking to add our own custom attributes. I already have one added here. And to add your own, simply click on add another attribute and type in plan or whatever you want your attribute name to be. Keep in mind, you do not have to add in the custom part. And also you can edit some things like the type, the minimum and maximum length. And also you cannot delete these. So once you've saved them, you cannot delete them. So I'm going to get rid of this one, and we can head over to VS Code, and we can start getting some things done. So under components, I'm going to create a new file called attributes. And all this code here can be cloned from the GitHub repo found in the description. You'll find all the code for my previous Cognito tutorials in there. So now that we're in attributes, we're going to import a few things. We're going to import React, use effect, use context, and use state. All this is coming from React, of course. And then we're also going to import the account context from the accounts file. Now, if we open that up, we'll see the account context holds a few different methods. One we're looking at in particular is get session. This will give us access to the current Cognito user as well as their attributes. Again, this file can be found in the GitHub repo found in the description. So now we're just going to export a default function. And inside, we're going to create a plan and set plan from the state. And this will have a default empty string. And then we're going to set a few things, which we'll be filling in mostly later on. But we're going to create a simple use effect here that is going to be ran whenever the component is first mounted. We're simply going to say todo fetch the current plan from Cognito. And then because we're going to have a form to submit all of this, we're going to have an onSubmit function, which will have an event passed in from the form. And we're simply going to prevent the default action of the form. And then we're going to say to do is update the plan on Cognito. And now we're going to return some basic JSX. We're just going to return a div. There'll be an H1 that says update your plan. There'll be a form below that with onSubmit being onSubmit. And then we're simply going to have an input with the value being plan. And onChange will be an inline function where we just call setPlan from event.target.value. And then we're going to have a button that'll have the type of submit. And then the text will be change plan. Pretty basic stuff. So whenever we click on this button, the onSubmit will run. And so what we're going to do is we're going to get the session. Whoops, we have to actually deconstruct get session from the use context hook, passing in the account context. We can actually access the get session method here. So we can now use get session, and that is a promise. So we have to use dot then, and we're going to destructure the user property of the object. So now we have access to the user, and now what we want to do is we want to create an array called attributes, and you can update multiple attributes at the same time. And we now have to import Cognito user attribute from Amazon Cognito Identity JS. Now inside of attributes, we are simply going to create a new Cognito user attribute, and this is going to have one object in the constructor. And inside we need a name and a value, both with capital N and capital V, just like this. The name is going to be custom colon plan, or whatever the name is of your custom attribute. We named ours plan, or at least I did, so yours should be custom colon plan. The value is going to be the plan variable, which is used in state right up here. So now that we have that, we can use user.updateAttributes. We can pass in the attributes, and there's a callback giving us an error and the result. So we're simply going to say, if there's an error, then console.error. We're just going to console log the error. We're also going to console log the results. This is fairly simple. We're going to go ahead and save this file, and then we're going to go into our app.js, and we're going to import it so we can display it on the screen. Can import attributes from components attributes, and then we're going to display at the bottom here. So if you save this, we go back over here, we see update your plan. We're going to type in testing, change plan. We see success. If we go over to our Cognito user and we refresh, we see custom plan is testing. If I change this to free and I change the plan, we see success again. I can refresh the user and it says free now. So that works. So now what we can do is we can go in and we're going to actually load that attribute into the input field whenever the page first loads. And if we look into the accounts file here, get session actually gets the attributes from user.getUserAttributes and puts them into the object. So what we can do is we can simply say get session.then. We get some data here about the user. We can console log that data to take a look inside the object. If we save this, we go back over here, we see data is right here, and we see custom plan is free. So now we can access that. We simply say set plan data index of custom colon plan. We save this, and if we refresh the page, we see it's now free by default. If we change this to testing, and we change the plan, we see success, and if we refresh again, it's now testing by default. So that's how you can update and read Cognito user attributes. You can use the predefined attributes here, and if you do that, you should not include the custom colon in the string. Thanks for watching this AWS tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, be sure to leave a comment down below or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description. If you want to learn more about AWS, consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.